Good morning, children, and welcome to all of you in online classes. Dear students, we are discussing the first chapter of Hornbill book, or the name of chapter is The Portrait of a Lady. This particular lesson, The Portrait of a Lady, has been written by one of the renowned, famous writer of our country, or his name is Khushwant Singh, who was born in 1915 and died in 2014, and worked as a lawyer, politician and diplomat. This particular story, dear students, in the previous lecture, in the previous video, I have told you that this particular story is a description of a lady, description in words of a lady who is luckily and fortunately grandmother of author Mr. Khushwant Singh. In previous video, dear students, I have told you the summary of the whole chapter, and today I am going to teach you line by line. So please open your book. The Portrait of a Lady means, the meaning of the title is ki description in words of a lady who is a grandmother of Khushwant Singh, the author of lesson. Or see, my grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. Here the narrator, here the author, Mr. Khushwant Singh, is telling that his grandmother was like other grandmother, as grandmother used to look like old, and an aged person. In the same way, his grandmother was also looking in the same way. Our writer is telling here, Khushwant Singh is telling here, that she had been old and wrinkled for 20 years that I have known her. Our writer has seen her grandmother wrinkled face, her physical appearance, and in the same physical appearance, in the same situation, in the same old age, for last 20 years. There was no change that was observed by author Khushwant Singh, writer Khushwant Singh, in last 20 years on the face, in the body of her grandmother. She was in the same stage and she was in the same position. People used to say, what? Next sentence, people said she had been once young and pretty. His elders, his family members, they used to tell that once his grandmother was young also and pretty also, attractive also, even she had a husband also. But the writer is telling ki it is hard to believe that her grandmother was in such way. She was young, she was pretty, she was having husband. This particular statement thought was definitely unconvincing to her. It was hard to believe because for the last 20 years he has seen his grandmother in the same position, same wrinkled face, same white hairs. Or the writer is telling slightly about his grandfather. Unfortunately, the writer never met his grandfather. He was knowing his grandfather through only picture, through only that photo which was hanging at the mantelpiece, above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. My grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. This much he was knowing only. He was knowing about his grandfather through that picture which was hanging above the mantelpiece. Or how his grandfather was looking in that picture which was hanging above the mantelpiece. Or he wore a big turban. His grandfather had worn a big turban and loose fitting clothes. And his long white beard covered the best part of his chest. And here is given, so this was all about his grandfather. This much only he was knowing about his grandfather, or that he was knowing through that picture which was hanging above the mantelpiece. He looked at least 100 years old. In that picture, it was seeming to the writer that his grandfather was about 100 years. Seeing the physical appearance which was given in that picture, either it was white beard, long grey beard, or it was the loose fitting clothes, or it was the other things. The writer's observation was that his grandfather was about 100 years when that photo was taken. He did not look a sort of person who had wife or children. After seeing his picture, nobody can say that the person was having wife and children. The person will surely and certainly say that such a person must have lots of grandchildren. It is all about grandfather. Here is written. Here. He did not look a sort of person who would have a wife or children. He looked as he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. So this was all about grandfather. Come on, again on grandmother. Because this lesson is about grandmother only, dear students. My grandmother was young and pretty. His grandmother was young and attractive. The thought was almost revolting. He heard from his family members, his elders, that his grandmother was once young and pretty attractive. But this thought was revolting. This thought was almost inconvincing to him. Means it was hard to believe the writer, it was hard to believe Mr. Khuswant Singh that his grandmother was once young and pretty. Because he was seeing his grandmother only in the same stage, in the same state for last 20 years. Same wrinkled face, having wrinkles, same white hairs, same physical appearance. See, often told us और व्हाट वाज द रूटीन व्हाट ग्रैंडमदर यूज्ड टू डू सी यूज्ड टू टेल अस मींस द चिल्ड्रन इंक्लूडिंग खुशवंत सिंह द गेम्स विच सी यूज्ड टू प्ले एज ए चाइल्ड तो हिज ग्रैंडमदर यूज्ड टू टेल द गेम्स विच सी वाज प्लेइंग इन हर चाइल्डहुड It seemed quite absolutely ridiculous. Writer here is telling ki that seemed quite absurd, quite ridiculous and undignified on her part. Because how she could do that? But the writer as a listener, writer and other children who were listening the games and stories told by grandmother, they treated it like fables, like old moral stories. Dear students, or this type of old moral stories, fables of prophets. A prophet who used to give the message of God to the children, including Khushwant Singh, they used to take the stories stated and told by grandmother just like the fables, just like the moral stories and messages. Understood? Which gives the message about the God. Here is given it like fables of prophets he used to tell us, or the writer used to heard the story and listen the story told by his grandmother. Like those moral stories, in that message is given by God. And the person who used to give the message of God is prophet. I want to tell you, dear students, in the second paragraph, first paragraph is over. In second paragraph, here is given the detail of his physical appearance, that how she looked like. She had always been short. Who had been? Grandmother of Khushwant Singh. She had always been short and slightly bent. She was slightly bending. Her body was slightly bending. Her face was crisscross wrinkles. Means there were many wrinkles. They were passing from one side to another side, running from everywhere to everywhere. No, we were certain she had been, as we had known her, old, so terribly old, or that she could not have grown older. And writer is telling his grandmother was staying in the same stage, in the same age. Where is it written? And had stayed at the same age for the last 20 years. Because for the last 20 years, the writer was observing and seeing his grandmother in the same physical appearance, in the same physical condition. There was no change. She could never have been pretty, attractive, but she has always been beautiful, beautiful by nature. Though the writer is telling, though she could not be very attractive, but she was beautiful by nature, beautiful by heart. She hobbled, she walked, here is given about the house in spotless white, without spots, without any blots, with one hang, and her one hang was resting, where it was resting, resting on her waist, to manage the balance, to keep the balance. Due to her old age, here is given ki one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, that bent of the body, that raised portion. Understood? She used to keep and she used to walk in such way, dear students, in the house. She used to keep her one hand on the waist to manage the balance of her body. Understood? Here is given to balance her stoop, that raised portion at the back, and other telling the beads of rosary, and other hands she used to always engage in telling the rosary. She used to engage in prayers. Again the writer is telling ki her silver locks were scattered on her face, her white hairs were scattered on her face, or her lips were constantly moving on inaudible prayers. Her lips was always continue constantly moving for what? Moving, be busy in inaudible prayer, the prayer which cannot be listened loudly, which cannot be hear loudly. Yes, she was beautiful. The writer is finally accepting that she was beautiful, beautiful by heart, beautiful by nature. Or she was like a winter landscape. Writer is just making comparison ki how her grandmother was looking like and her physical face and body was looking like, just like a winter landscape in the mountain which is covered with snow, and expanse of pure white serenity, that is a expansion of peace and contentment. Peace and contentment, the grandmother was looking like that. Now dear students, the third paragraph, my grandmother and I were good friends. Writer is telling the grandmother and writer both were good friends. How? Because they lived together, they talked together, they slept together, they used to spend most of the time together. Due to that they became close, or they liked to each other also. My parents left me when they went to the city. So writer was living with his grandmother, or her grandmother, you always help her for what? For making ready, for getting ready to the school. Even she used to sing the prayers loudly, hoping that the writer will memorize and learn. But the writer has written in this book ki I listened because I loved her voice. Writer was listening the prayer of his grandmother because he loved her voice. He understood? But here is given ki but he has never taken pain to memorize and to learn. So this is all about today, dear students, and next portion I will teach you in the next video. Thank you. You will write the explanation of taught portion. Thank you, dear students.